Hey, Shalom. I want to give all praise and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Rekah, Kodash. Double honors goes out to the other apostles of Great Millstone for teaching me this truth. Also want to acknowledge all the Akiam who are pushing this truth with sincerity, all right? So, you know, I just wanted to do a quick hitter on Alexander the Great. That's the who you see in the image right in front of you. And then I want to pull out some, well, I'm actually just going to read some scriptures. That way the image will just stay on there. Because I'm going to read about him in the scriptures. Through the Spirit, you know, we'll do that. These are some more statues which are depicting Alexander the Great, but as we call him, Alexander the Freak, all right, who was a Greek. Here you go. Here's some more images of that devil. And when really, when you go into the history, like the elders were saying, Elder Apostle Tahari was saying, hey, Alexander was, he was kissing our ass back then, man. You know, being a serpent, you know. But let's go to Maccabees and let's read about him real quick. First Maccabees chapter 1, and it happened after that, Alexander, son of Philip, and the Macedonian, who came out of the land of Chittim, had smitten Darius, king of the Persians and Medes, that he reigned in his stead, the first over Greece, and made many wars and won many strongholds and slew the kings of the earth. All right, and at that time, the king, the most powerful king on the earth was King Darius, king of the Persians and the Medes, because during the Medo-Persian Empire, you know, that captivity was followed by the Greek captivity, the Edomite captivity, all right? It was his first dominion on, you know, of that realm, all right? The Edomite having power over the nations. And to this day, ever since the Greek captivity, we're still in the Edomite captivity, all right? Because Greeks, Romans, Europeans, Americans, you know, the ones who are the founders, the ones they call the forefathers of America, those are Edomites, right? They're Greeks and Romans in history. So let me keep reading. Verse 3. And he went through the ends of the earth and took spoils of many nations. And he's still doing that, by the way. The Edomite still goes to the ends of the earth to take other countries and other nations' resources. But he goes in there crafty. He says they got weapons of mass destruction, or he says they're a threat to America. And he lies, but he uses those justifications so that the public doesn't really know what's going on, where they're just taking advantage of nations and taking their spoils. All right? So when you look up that word spoil, here it is. We'll read spoils definition, plural noun, goods stolen or taken forcibly from a person or a place. All right. So that's what this so-called white man did, right? That's why it says he spoiled. He spoiled our people. He spoiled our land. He spoils everything, man. And that's what he does to this day. He's spoiling. The Edomite is the spoiler. Is he not? Did he not take this land by force? You know? Through the Spirit, I was watching the movie 1492, Conquest of Paradise. And I recommend every brother watch that movie or buy it. You know, it's like 10 bucks on YouTube. Or however, whatever app you use to buy your movies. 1492 is the name of the movie. Since I'm talking about it, let me just pull it up. This is it right here. Good movie, man. But you know, they portray Christopher Columbus they make him the good guy when you watch this, so, you know, they don't tell you the full story. But, you know, check this movie out, man. I recommend every single brother watch this movie. Because now that you know this truth, it's a heavy movie to watch, man. Go check it out. It's worth your money, too. It's like 2.5 hours long, all right? Let's go back to that original devil that we were exposing. See, and the internet, man, it's a great tool for us to learn this truth, man. We got everything that we need at our fingertips, all through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. You know, you can look up anything, brothers. So that's what we got to be diligent, man, doing this work. Well, let's just, for the sake of the video, let me see. We'll throw that one out. There he is, Alexander the Freak. So now I'm on 1 Maccabees chapter 3, or verse 3, 1 and 3. And went through the ends of the earth and took spoils of many nations. Now you know what that word spoil means, take forcibly. In so much that the earth was quiet before him, whereupon he was exalted, and his heart was lifted up. And heart is mind. So the Edomite's mind was lifted up after he took all the spoils of the other nations. And the nation he spoiled the most was the nation of Israel, right? We keep reading. And he gathered a mighty strong host and ruled over countries and nations and kings who became tributaries unto him. And after these things, he fell sick and perceived that he should die. Wherefore he called his servants such as were honorable and had been brought up with him from his youth, and parted his kingdom among them while he was yet alive. So he parted his kingdom while he was, before he died, he was picked out all his new leaders, you know, and Ptolemy was one of those leaders, which is the, he was the ruler in Egypt. Verse 7, so Alexander reigned 12 years and then died, and his servants bear rule, every one in his place. All right, and I'm on 1 Maccabees 1 and 9. It says, and after his death, they all put crowns upon themselves. So did their sons after them many years, and evils were multiplied in the earth. All right, so the scriptures tells you when the Greeks took over, the Edomites, evils multiplied in the earth. How much more now? We're past Greek captivity. We're past Roman captivity, you know. We're not dealing with the European, you know. This is a long kingdom that been given for the Edomite to rule over the earth, you know. Let me get really quick, Job, because like I say, you can't do a lesson on Esau, Edom, without bringing out Job 9 and 24. This is Job 9:24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? So the earth is given to the hand of the wicked. And this is the dude it started with. The Edomites are the wicked. Alexander the Greek, he was the first Edomite ruler to have dominion over the planet Earth, or over the ancient world in those times. All right, the next verse I want to get is talking about the vision in the book of Daniel, right? It says a vision of the ram, goat, and the horn. It's chapter 8, and I'm going to just jump to verse 20. It says, the ram, this is talking about Alexander the Greek, all right? The ram which thou sawest having two horns are the kings of Media and Persia. I'm sorry, those are the ram, it shows you in history that Darius the Mede and Persian king, he was conquered by the goat. Who's the goat? Alexander the Greek. All right. So let me start again. Verse 20. The ram which thou sawest having two horns are the kings of Media and Persia. And the rough goat is the king of Grecia. And the great horn that is between his eyes is the first king. So that first king of Greece, we just read it, was Alexander the Greek. So now let's read 22. Now that being broken, whereas four stood up for it, which is the number four. Four kingdoms shall stand up out of the nation, but not in his power. See? So what are those kingdoms, man? Those kingdoms are what? Greek, Rome, Europe, you know, basically any of the, you know, modern Europe, and then which would eventually become Babylon America. All right, let me read it again. Now that being broken, whereas four stood up for it, four kingdoms shall stand up out of the nation, but not in his power. All right, so meaning there was going to be four Edomite kingdoms to keep us in captivity, but not while while Alexander the Great was alive. No, he's had many leaders and presidents and rulers since Alexander the Greek. And now, you know, this is it, man. The four kingdoms shall stand up out of the nation, but not in his power. Let's see. And in the latter time of their kingdom, when the transgressors are come to the full, a king of fierce countenance and understanding dark sentences shall stand up, and his power shall be mighty, but not by his own power. And he shall destroy wonderfully, and shall prosper and practice, and shall destroy the mighty and the holy people. So what has the Edomite done? He's destroyed the mighty and the holy people. And it all started out with this guy right here, man, Alexander the Greek. And how do they destroy us? Why? Because they don't teach you the laws in Babylon America, you know, or any of the four kingdoms that stood up, you know, after his power. Let's see. Verse 25. And through his policy he shall cause craft to prosper in his hand, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall destroy many. He shall also stand up against the prince of princes, but he shall be broken without hand. All right? So who magnifies himself? See, and by peace shall destroy many. So he tells you he comes in peace, but he's a liar, right? Because deceit is in his heart. He'll put his arm around you, speak soft words in your ear, and then turn around and smite you. You know, that's the nature of Esau Edom. He shall stand up against the prince of princes, but he shall be broken without hand. And so who is that? Yahweh Shai. Because these Edomites, in these last days, they're going to get ready to take on war with the angels. All right? And the vision of the evening and the morning which was told is true. Wherefore, shut thou up the vision, for it shall be for many days. And I, Daniel, fainted and was sick certain days. Afterward, I rose up and did the king's business, and I was astonished at the vision, but none understood it. See, the only one who understands it is going to be the Israelites, the prophets. So let's get that. Amos 3 and 7. The reason why Daniel was able to understand that vision of the Edomites taking power with four kingdoms after Alexander the Greek, who was the first in Greek's stead, right? He was the first, or steed, however you want to say it. He was the first ruler of the Edomites when they conquered the known world of during the time of, you know, Alexander. And that's why they call their sports figures the goat, because of that rough goat, right? Let's go watch. Let's see. And then another thing showing you that this white man is the devil, the so-called white man. Let's see here. What is? So, Baphomet, right? Let's go. Oops. Well, maybe this will pull it. Yeah, there it is. So what is the Baphomet, man? Let's read it. Baphomet is a deity that the Knights Templar were accused of worshiping, right? They're accused. But who were the Knights Templar? You see? So Baphomet is a goat, man. You know? Look it. Since 1856, the name Baphomet has been associated with the Sabbatic goat. See? half human, half animal, male and female, good and evil. See? Let's get some more images. So this white man is the devil, man. And he's the goat. That's why he calls his sports figures the goats. Right? Does he not call Michael Jordan the goat? Does he not call Tom Brady the goat? And they honor the goat, right? Do you know? And when they say goat, they in sports, it stands for greatest of all time. But hey, this is what they're really worshiping. When you worship the goat, when you're paying homage to the goat in sports, or whether it's boxing, MMA, whatever, you're coming in the spirit of this goat, this Edomite, man. All right? So look at this, man. Let me zoom it in. Is that not a goat? With two serpents on his stomach. Look, he's got the children of Israel on the right worshiping him, and the Edomite on the left worshiping him. See? That's the two-thirds that little Judite boy looks like in the picture. He represents the two-thirds, because why? The two-thirds and the Edomites all, and the heathen, they worship this goat. So, with that, I want to give all praise and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Rukakadash. Double honors goes out to the elder apostles of Great Millstone for teaching me this truth. Shalom to the elect.